Look at each other there. Would you put your arm around it? Have you put your arm around it? Would you look at me again, both of you?
Do you sloppy? Go on then.
Thank you. dogs, perfect. Big group. That's great smiles, guys. And just get one more. Make sure nobody blinks, guys.
Perfect. Anybody else your side?
Is say it. you this way. I feel for all the times
dear Aunt Far, and I hope you have a good day, and I hope you dance the night away. Now, I'd like to point out that there is a camera on the table there for everyone, so please take plenty of pictures, and the more embarrassing pictures, the better, to be honest. If you really want an embarrassing picture, you can wait to see John dancing later on. Right, I'm going to call on Martin Brown,
Geraldine, John and guests. Firstly, on behalf of Joseph and myself, I want to congratulate Geraldine and John on their marriage today and wish them the very best of health, happiness and their future lives together. And I hope every day will be as happy for them as today and bring as much happiness to them. Well, we had a lovely time in the cathedral today, and a special thanks to my good friend Father Michael Riley for the beautiful Mass and marriage ceremony. The beautiful music by the Barrett Sisters, of which Geraldine is a big fan, and the sacristans of the cathedral for having the church in such splendid condition. It gives me great pleasure to invite John into the Brown family. Josephine and I are a long time waiting for a son, John. And we're very happy. And we're very happy that John found and chose you for us, John. The first time we met John was 2 days before Christmas 2006. Sean McCarthy can vouch for it, under a bush, halfway down the field, this side of Ballina. You see, Geraldine was on her way home for Christmas with a big present to care for me. She was in such a hurry, she thought she would take a shortcut across a few fields. But unfortunately, only got as far as this big bush. When I got to where the car left the road, went down with a torch to see it, I was met by this big man in the dark. Called John, who today is my son-in-law. Geraldine said it was her friends who were talking with her who rang him to give him a lift to Ben Mullet. Believe that and didn't believe anything. How ironic for me that I just have worked for over 40 years in the bogs of Arras from Corrie to Kiltane, from Shamore to Rathmorgan, and having said goodbye to him in 2010, I now find myself with a new Irish connection. I will be visiting Belmullet and Drum in the future. And I also look forward to meeting some of my workmates, particularly Michael Monaghan down there today later on. What can I say about Geraldine, the oldest of her three daughters, who was and still is a modern daughter. Being the oldest, I know what it feels like, Geraldine. She always had to lead the way from the first day at school to the first one in college and live away from home and make her way through life in the big city. She has been a role model for Jacinth and Sinead, and a good job she's done. At the moment, she's working in Dublin, but hopefully in a few years, we will get John herself nearer the Atlantic. And John, if she makes you as happy for the rest of your life as she has made Josephine tonight for the past number of years, then you're happy. And I know John, that you'll look after her well as well. I would like to thank the extended Brown and Cusack families and friends, and Geraldine and John's family's friends, for your presence here today. And I also would like to remember the few people who are absent, two good friends of ours, and buried their sisters during the week. May they rest in peace. And also my own Uncle Willie, who was to be here, but he ended up in hospital in Castlecourt last Saturday. Thankfully he's on the main to his back in Swinford, so hopefully he'll be out over the weekend. I hope you'll pardon me if I single out one guest for a special mention. That's my mother down here in front of me. Look after our girls whenever Josie was sick or in hospital, and has been an inspiration to us all our lives. I know it's a proud day for you, Mum, to see your oldest and first grandchild married. And I'd like you all to be outstanding while I propose a toast to my mother.
Nanny Brown.
To Nanny.
To Nanny Brown. Best of luck, Annie. Hopefully, it won't be too long before we have another one. There's a few candidates I'm looking at. Finally, congrats and best wishes again to Geraldine and John. And to all you down there who have travelled, as Noel said, long distances from all corners of Ireland, my cousin Margaret and Noel over from England, and maybe people in John's side from across the water. Thanks very much for coming, and I hope you have a great evening and dance the night away. And I just want to say to the younger ones down there, when you get tired and motivated about 12 o'clock, it's a good over 60s disco for us for our age group to dance the night away.
To you is a toast of all your friends to you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to rise and to raise our glass in toast to the bride and groom.
I just thought I'd want to say a few little words because anyone who knows me knows I'm a good talker and I really have to have the last say of the day. So there's no point changing it today. First of all, I want to thank everybody for coming. I know everyone has already, but it really is, it's just a measure of how special the day is to see everybody here. And we really, really, really appreciate it in these tough times that everyone takes the day off on a Friday. And since I started teaching, I've been a great traveller. I love travels, holidays, sunshine, and I'll be on the first plane out of here, even if it's from Dublin to Knock, I'm on that airplane. So a few years ago, myself and my five best friends headed off to Australia for a year. Had a great time, we had a ball. And in the end, it was two of us that came back at the same time, myself and Michelle Mack. We were devastated, didn't want to be at home, had no interest in Dublin or working, so we decided, right, we'll go back next year. We'll work a year, we'll head back. We're delighted with ourselves. Thoughts of lovely Melbourne and Perth, then, you know, it'll all be great. Until in one of our many, many nights in Copper's, no, I'm about to tell you a secret. One of our many, many nights in Flannery's in Dublin, I was introduced to John Cusack, who, funnily enough, I'd heard of when I was in a very pokey little apartment with Sharon McAndrew over there again, in Melbourne. And I'd heard of him, I had no idea how I knew his name was good or bad, but I met him that night. And on the very same night, Michelle Mack, my other partner, Brian, met Stephen Riley, John's friend. So Stephen and Michelle are now engaged to get married in August, and myself and John are obviously here today, so I think it was one of our better nights out of town. Funnily enough, there's no more mention of Australia. Most people will know that John and I are polar opposites. I'm a talker. I'm loud, you'll hear me before you see me, I'm the first one on the dance floor, whereas John is quiet, reserved, and fantastic, but you'll never hear John before you see him. So, opposites do attract, definitely. What I do have to say is that when I often heard when you find your man, you marry somebody like your father, and John is he could be my dad's son, more than I could be his daughter. They are so alike in every way possible. Their personality, their mannerisms, they're both gentlemen, John is a handyman, exactly like my dad. Any job you want done, John will do it. And Sinead actually has adopted him as her father in Dublin for every job that he's doing in the house, car fixing, hubcaps taken off, you name it, John is there. So he has just replaced dad for Sinead. And the girls adore him, and my mum and dad adore him, and I think we're very lucky because John is the same with the girls and my family. He thinks the world of them. And I suppose the biggest compliment I can pay to John today is that you are just like my dad, a gentleman in every way, and I know that you'll always be very good to me, just as my dad has been to Mal and all of us. With John, but also with the Cusack family. I'll never forget the first night I went out on Easter a few years ago to meet them. I was as sick as a dog, as my Auntie Mary would just cry, and my mother. I sat for 3 hours in the sitting room, dressed in a cream dress and black tights, waiting for the clock to come, and I'd be out for 7:30 that evening, and I was in a bad way. But the second I walked in, I met Bonnie and Sean, Michael. It was just fine. They were just so warm, so welcoming. Then I went to Helen's house, and Helen and Sean were there, and they were equally the same. And from that day to this, it's home from home for me. It's just the nicest house to win, and everyone here knows Bonnie from him, but we'll just say it exactly the same. I'll never have the greatest mother-in-law. I'll never be able to tell that story, because she's just extra, extra special. And I'm so lucky now that I have two fantastic friends. My old family, of course, are fantastic. Giuseppe is just my wedding coordinator beside me. She's fantastic. Organised the best hen ever. She's a great sister. We teach directly across the road from each other in Dublin. She's great. She's fantastic. Sinead is too. But you're all going to picture of Sinead tonight. She gets embarrassed easily, but she's fantastic. So whatever John has said of that, she's not looking for a husband, but she is single. But she's But Sinead is fantastic too. I have the two best sisters ever. Probably don't have a brother. I don't think we'd be able for one. I don't think any man would survive in the house with just three women when we're all there together. But they've just been fantastic bridesmaids and sisters and friends. So thanks, girls. You're the best. And then there's my other bridesmaid, Gillian. Gillian has been there with my second John from day one. When I'm giving out to John, Gillian is there to give out to me and tell me to stop. When John is giving out, when John is maybe not paying himself the best, Gillian is there to give out to John. There's been many of my confederates and coppers where she's taken him on when I've stormed off and told him what's what. So for Gillian to be still sitting here today with the two of us still together and her bridesmaid is a measure of we must be doing okay, Gillian. But she's a fantastic friend in every way and I couldn't have done it. I couldn't have stood in the auto without her today. So thanks, Gillian, for everything. That brings me to Dublin, to my school. In 2002, I walked into a school called St. Peter's, a teacher practice in third year, and I was horrified because I had to go all the way on two buses to the far side of Dublin, and I had no idea where I was going, what I was going to, and I thought I'd never do it 4 weeks out on two buses. And the first day ever I walked in, I met Matt Hurley, the smiliest principal you'll ever come across and the most lovely man, and he brought me up to my teacher in a fourth and fifth class, who looked as shocked as I did when I walked into the room. She had no idea that I was coming. And that is my very best friend, Orla Sheehy. And she was the same age as me, smiling, happy, and from that day on, we've been the best of friends and gone through everything together. And Orla just had her little baby there a couple of months ago. Alexander's here with us today, but she's been outstanding in helping me in every aspect of the wedding from day one to this morning. She's just been fantastic. So thanks, Orla, for all your help. And on top of that, I have the best staff in the world. There's 25 of them here in Tobin today, and you'll definitely hear them before you see them later on. And they've made a full weekend of it, and they're more like a family to me in Dublin. They're there for me. No matter what happens, they're there for me. And as soon as I got engaged, the celebration started, and they only finished up when I finished school on the 22nd of December, and they've been just fantastic. So to all my friends down there from St. Peter's, thanks a million, girls and lads. You made it all very, very special, and I know what we're going to talk about. And to finish up, I just want to mention my mum, who is obviously stunning today, absolutely beautiful. She's helped me in every way to plan this wedding. At the end of the phone, can you do this, Matt? Can you do that? Can you make this call? Nothing has ever been too much for her. She's just amazing. And she's a great friend. And I'm really lucky to have such a good friend in my man, because we get on like a house on fire. And poor dad does often be very angry with four of us in the house. So I'll just read this bit out just in case. So also there's my nanny, who we mentioned a lot, but she's extra special, and we're so blessed to have her here, and I'm so blessed to have had her all these years, and she's just in great form, but just be careful later on. One brandy in her and she'll be tearing up that dance floor. There's no need for a stick, she tells me all the time, so just watch out for her. She'll be the one in the middle of us all, so she will. And my Auntie Mary, who's my godmother, she's a second mother to me. She was in the house with me this morning, all morning, and she has settled us all week. The table plan disaster, she was there to settle us. When Mam was getting excited, she was there to settle us. When Sinead took my exfoliator last week, she was there to settle us. So all of the minor little dramas, Auntie Mary has been there to settle us. So even though I know that it's not tradition, I would just like everyone to be upstanding and propose a toast to the four most special women. My Mam, my nanny, my Auntie Mary, and Viney.
A special to
Thanks very much. Have a great night.
Well done, Jordy.
Well done.
combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. And our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go and how come it's so hard. It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together.
They've taken fantastic song, They Really Have, by Mr. Tom Baxter. Get your cameras ready, ladies and gentlemen, it's Better.
It's not the same, and the only way to say it is faith. It's better. I can't conceal it. This way you feel.
Let's see you clap those hands, come on! I promised John I wouldn't leave them on their own tonight, so I'm going to welcome a quiet party to join them on the floor. Give a big round of applause to Josephine and Martin! Jacinta, also Sinead, Julian, Sean and Michael, and a big mention to our beautiful flower girls, Cara and me.
Now, I'm not from there.
by the gas works. St. Peter's Creek, let's sing this.
Yeah.
Geraldine, you want one more from the center, what do you think? Would you like one more? Yeah. We can't hear you, would you like one more?
Yeah. 50 years.
Absolutely, no question. yourself. Email everybody that you want to be here. He's not here. But here's a very special song. Wish you the best.
Let's go. with the Pharaoh. And so say all of us.
Let's go.